Welcome back for another example of solving a system of three equations with three unknowns using the method of elimination. To keep things organized, let's go and label our three equations. We'll label the first equation, equation A, second equation, equation B, and the third equation, equation C. What's a little different about this system is that the third equation, equation C, only contains two variables, which is actually good news because now if we work with equations A and B to eliminate the z terms, we'll already have two equations with two unknowns which we can use to solve this system. So normally we select any two equations and eliminate any variable, but in this case we're going to select equation A and B and eliminate the z terms. Which means we want to add the equations together to eliminate the z terms, so we want the z terms to be opposites. So we multiply equation A by negative 1 and add it to equation B, we can eliminate the z term. So we're going to multiply negative 1 times equation A and then add equation B. So let's go ahead and do that. Negative 1 times equation A would be negative 3x plus 8y minus z equals positive 14. We're going to leave equation B the same. Notice how the z terms are opposites. So this would be 0, so we'll have negative 2x plus 7y equals positive 9. Let's go ahead and call this equation D. Now notice we have two equations that contain x and y, equation C and equation D. So we'll use these two equations and solve for x and y using elimination. So we'll solve this as a system to find the value of x and y, and then we'll perform back substitution to find the value of z. So we want to solve the system x minus 3y equals negative 4 and negative 2x plus 7y equals 9. And again, this was equation C and we called this equation D. Let's go ahead and eliminate the x terms now. Notice how if this was positive 2x and we added these two equations together, the x terms would add to 0. So we'll multiply equation C by 2 and add it to equation D. So 2 times equation C would be 2x minus 6y equals negative 8. And equation D is going to stay the same. Notice how the x terms are eliminated. This sums to 0. And we have 1y, or just y, equals negative 8 plus 9 is positive 1. Now we know for the solution, y must equal positive 1. Now we'll perform back substitution to find the value of x and the value of z. So to find the value of x, we'll use one of these equations here that only contain x and y, since now that we know y is equal to 1. So using equation C, we could also use equation D, but using equation C, notice how x minus 3y, but y is 1, must equal negative 4. So this is x minus 3 equals negative 4. So add 3 to both sides and we have x equals negative 1. Now we'll go back to one of the original equations to find the value of z. Let's go ahead and use equation B. Using equation B, we have x minus y plus z equals negative 5. Well, x is negative 1. Y is positive 1, so we have minus 1 plus z equals negative 5. So we have negative 2 plus z equals negative 5. Add 2 to both sides, and we have z equals negative 3. Now we have the solution to our system. Often the solution is listed as an ordered triple because if we graph these three planes in space, they would intersect in the point with an x coordinate of negative 1, a y coordinate of positive 1, and a z coordinate of negative 3. Let's go ahead and graph these three planes in space and see if we can tell where this point would be. So here's the graph of the three planes in space. It's a little hard to tell because two of the planes are very close together, but the point of intersection would be this point right here that's on all three planes. If we we rotate this, we might get a better view. Again, it would be this point right here with an x-coordinate of negative 1, a y-coordinate of positive 1, and a z-coordinate of negative 3. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.